So I'm going to give you some problems to think about. These are all sort of standard problems, but they're good to get started. So problem number one concerns this object right here. Okay. Can you see that? Does it look interesting? Okay, it's got a flap. Okay, it just flaps there. There's nothing hidden about it. And I made it out of a single piece of paper without any glue or... I just made some cuts and made this. So the first problem is how do you make such a thing? Okay. So maybe I'll put it over here. Okay, so that's problem number one. Problem one. How to make... Okay, now I have to draw this thing. Well, I've already... So the video camera's already got it, but I have to draw it anyway. Okay, so this might be a little bit challenging. So there's roughly... it's got something like that, okay. So there's a sort of a piece that goes up like this, and then there's this fold. Maybe the fold will be like that. And then there's a piece that goes like this. And then the other piece carries on like this. Okay, so this is the fold here. Does that look like it?
Explain the fold.
Yeah, okay, so there's a fold here, and there's a kind of a fold on this side. So that part comes up to that fold, and that part comes up to that fold. So, okay, behind here there's something. Okay. How to make this with a single paper. And no glue. All right, so there's problem number one. And here's problem number two. Okay, this goes back to the famous 19th century puzzle maker named Sam Lloyd, who also created lots of chess puzzles and other things. So what you do is you have, the ingredients are, you need a shirt. With lots of buttons and holes for the buttons. Okay? And you also need a pencil. Well, it doesn't have to be that big, but okay. It's a large, enlarged view. There's a pencil. And from the pencil, you have a loop. You've got a piece of string, which is looped like this. So this is a pencil with a loop. And the loop is not big enough to go over the pencil. Okay, even if you pull it tight, it's not big enough to go over the pencil. So with a loop, which is smaller than the pencil. Okay, and so these are the ingredients, and then what we do is, if you know how to do it, what you do is you take the shirt, and you can actually do it on with somebody's shirt. If you have one of these things, you can do it. You say, "What? Look the other way for a second," and you do something quickly. And then afterwards, this is before, and then after, you end up with something that looks like this. Okay. Okay. So here's our our shirt. The button's there. Okay, so we've taken one of the holes, and what happens? Maybe I'll call this pencil yellow. Okay, so the pencil is now like this. And what about the loop? Maybe it'll be purple. There's our purple loop. The loop looks like this. It goes through here. Then it comes out the back. And goes under.
So it only uses one hole of the shirt.
Yeah, it just uses one hole of the shirt. Okay, so so the pencil is now attached to the shirt, but this part goes over. Let me try to make that a little bit more clear. So there's that there. That goes into the hole, and then outside here. Oh yeah, we need to preserve holes. This is topology. Yeah, right.
Okay, thank you. Okay, but so is that double piece of string everywhere?
Huh? This is a solid piece of string. This is a solid piece of string.
You draw it with double.
Okay. I'll draw it. I was just making it a little bit thicker. I want to make it clear that this is in front, and that's behind.
So
the thing goes in the hole and then comes out sort of dot 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 through there. It comes out the back. If this was on top, then we could just pull the pencil out.
Yeah.
Right? But it's looped under, so now the pencil is stuck. Do you agree? The pencil is stuck. And so the question is, explain how this trick is done. You can also always make a model and try it out. It actually works once you figure out how to do it.